Welcome back. This is Navisworks Advanced Clash Detection, Part 7 of 9.
You know, can you imagine how many do we have in the entire model, right? So this is why we don't do visual inspection only. We don't rely on ourselves to do the inspection because we could miss something. So we're going to use the home menu Clash Detective command to open the Clash Detective window and select the Add Test command. The Add Test command allows us to give this a name. The name would be something that is very specific to what we're trying to do. Are we going to report on the entire structural model versus the entire MEP model? Probably not. We wanted something specific, such as structural framing and ductwork. So ductwork is ducts, duct fittings, and duct accessories, right? So in the standard version of the window, on the left-hand side, we have structural, STR. On the right-hand side, we have MEP, which is mechanical, electrical, and plumbing. What we really want is to dig deeper into the model and find items that are specific of a specific category. So we use the find items command in the home menu. The find items window opens up and we are able to select the structural model and then set the criteria for selection, such as category, name, condition is equal, and the category name is going to be structural framing. That's the only category we have in the structural model. When we check the box for find all, when you click on find all, Navisworks will find all the structural framing in the model. All right. Once we found them, we can go to sets. Sets are made up of selection sets and search sets. We will use the binoculars. Not the one on the left, the binoculars, just to create a search set. The search set is important because it updates every time you reload the model. We will give this a name, and the name is structural framing based on the Revit category. Next, we will move to the MEP model, and then go on the right-hand side and select, do the same thing as before. We're searching for category, name, equals, ducts. Then the next row is category name equals duct fittings. And the third one would be duct accessories. Again, same thing, category name equals duct accessories. When we click on find all, you will be surprised that Navisworks is not capable of finding those components. Okay, and the reason for that is because we are telling Navisworks that we are applying three conditions on the same search. It doesn't work like that way. It has to be or. So we do a right click on duct fittings and select or condition, right click on the duct accessories, select or, and then find all, it will find them. And here they are. All the duct work in the building, including fittings and accessories. We will go to our sets dialog box on the left-hand side and select the binoculars to save it as a mechanical ducts, fittings, and accessories. So this is the three categories in under one search set because it's one system, right? All right, once we have these two search sets, we can continue to find all the categories in the building. But for this particular video, we're not going to continue. We're going to just stop and then go back and then see how we can set up our clash detection for these categories. Okay, so back to Clash Detective, right? Just click on the command one more time and then pin the dialog box in place. And I'm going to show you three different ways that you can search for these categories. You can either expand the folder and select the category by name from that folder, Or, and that's the first method, right? But sometimes it doesn't work. So what's the next best thing? Next best thing is to search under properties, right? The product came from the BIM authoring tool such as Revit. So you're gonna search under element, then after element is category, element, then category, then name, and then you would go to the structural framing. Okay, so this is just a different way to achieve the same result. This is on selection A on the left. On the right, we have selection B. It will do the same thing for the element, category, and then we'll select our ducts, duct fittings, and duct accessories. Element, category, name, ducts, hold control key down, and select duct fitting, duct accessories. So this is the second method of working with properties. The third method, which is my preferred method, is the sets. Sets are, the preferred way of working is using search sets, which updates every time you reload the model. And since you already have them, you already made them, we don't have to do anything, just select the ones that we already have. So we are going to be rest assured that the structure framing on the left and the mechanical duct on the right is the right set that we have created ourselves. We will set the tolerance to zero and click on run test. And then immediately Navisworks is able to find 102 clashes between structure framing and mechanical ductwork. The framing is shown in red on the right-hand side, and the ductwork is shown in green. So the clashes are numbered 1 through 102, and our friend, the avatar here, is in the way. But as I said before, you could turn him off using the go back to Navisworks options and turn off the third person, right? You can go to each view and do that under viewpoint, realism, and uncheck the box for a third person. That will do it as well. But we'll do it for every view, so you have to kind of repeat that 100 times. That's not fun. So preferably, in this case, you don't want to have the guy with the hard hat unless you're doing a navigation or a type thing with a navigation wheel. So we go through different clashes, we kind of check them out, and every one of them is valid, right? Between a structural element and a duct or elbow or something like that. This one in particular is of concern. So what we're going to do is going to assign it to a specific trade, such as a mechanical engineer, or if you are a general contractor, BIM manager in the field, you'd assign it to the mechanical contractor. And you would give them instructions on what action to take, right? So the purpose of this is to create a clash report that we will be sending out to all the team members and have them take action on it. And then we meet next week in the Monday morning meeting. We can, review what action they have taken, right? So we're giving the mechanical contractor some instruction what to do, right? Basically, they have to move the ductwork to avoid the beam, because the beam is not moving, really, unless there is something wrong with the structural design.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.